After getting started with embedded Swift in the previous video, I tried a smart light example of a meta framework using Swift. I know I don't always succeed on the first try. Unfortunately, there was an issue while connecting with the homebridge device. I'm using Apple TV here. During the process of adding the meta accessory in the home app from my iPhone, it just said it's connecting. A screen was displayed saying that it couldn't connect to the network. I felt like I need to use the latest version, so I updated the SDK and IDF of all development environments. Just in case, Apple TV also updated the tvOS 18 beta version. I thought I had built all my environments the same as the version used in the WWDC demo, so I looked elsewhere for the root cause of this issue. But ultimately, this was all a waste of time. This smart light example was built immediately after changing the target to ESP32C6 and flashed on the device. The issue here seems to be occurring in the node event handler and node attribute identify for some unknown reason. I never encountered this kind of issues while building the Matter project with ESP32S3. Therefore, I thought the issue might be with embedded Swift rather than the ESP-IDF and ESP-Matter issues. Just in case, I also changed the Swift version to the latest version, but the result was the same. I came across mentioning a workaround for this issue. This is an issue because the main function keeps delivering. It is said a while loop is added at the end of the main function to prevent the main function from exiting. What? A Fourier? As you can see, the code structure is very simple. Of course, it only looks like this because there is a wrapper API and each is implemented separately in embedded Swift. After the Matter application was started, I believe that it was designed to loop internally, so I thought it was created so that the necessary data could be communicated by registering a callback function or something else. Anyway, as per the workaround he mentioned, I added a while loop here. Let's see the result. On the left, I placed a screen that outputs the log from the current device. If you have any issues, please compare them. It starts connecting again. This time, I can see an update, adding to home. Finally, the connection is successful. It goes the same way as with other accessories. Now, it has been properly added to the HomeKit, so you can control it from anywhere. You can control this accessory through a HomeKit even when you are away from home. You don't have to worry about connectivity. You can see that it's working great without any issues. Even if it operates without an issue, it does not mean that the root cause has been resolved. Apple's official demos and tutorials clearly showed it operating normally without this workaround, so I believe they will provide a new version that fixes this issue. Therefore, it seems we need to wait a little longer until then. This is my opinion. Some people think positively or negatively about embedded Swift. I don't know the future of this either. However, as a developer, it is natural to be interested in new things. I hope Apple provides an official solution to this issue soon. After that, it's possible to create new work based on that. Alright, that's it for today. Thank you for watching. See you on the next project.